In this video, I want to share my top 7 tips and tricks for ActiveCampaign with you, because when I got started with ActiveCampaign, I just wasted so much time to figure everything out because there's just so much possible. And honestly, I was really a bit overwhelmed. So these are the tips and tricks that I wish I would have known when I just got started with ActiveCampaign. So let's just dive right into the first one, that is about how you should name your tags. So tags are really handy. They're like little labels that you can add to a contact, and those tags will tell you who that person is, what they're interested in, maybe which pages they visited. You can do all kinds of things with tags. So needless to say, tags inside ActiveCampaign are really fundamental, and that's also why it's really important that you have a clear naming convention. So like a structure to name your tag, because otherwise a few months from now, it will be like one big mess. So let me show you what I am using. So this is the naming convention that I stick to for all my tags. So I always start with a category, like the main category of what happened, then the action, so the thing that actually happened, a little bit more specific, and then context, what was acted on, and then some optional metadata. And as you see here, I also use brackets, colons, and dashes to keep things nice and organized. So what I recommend doing, create a document like this and write this down. And if you want to go one step further, I would also really recommend to write down a list of the major tags that you use in your business, so that when you're working on an automation, you can just look at your major list and then you're like, ah, that's how I named that tag. So this is what I did over here. I will also put a link to this in the description below so that you can take a look at it and change it to your own needs. And then we're going to talk about the next tip, which is about lists. So when I got started with ActiveCampaign, I somehow thought that you needed to create a list for every little thingy. That I needed to create a list for my lead magnets, that I needed to create a list for my challenges, that I needed to create a list for my giveaways, like basically a list for everything. So in the end, I maybe had like 50 different, maybe 50 is a bit much, but like, I don't know, maybe 20 different lists. And this was getting super messy because people were getting into multiple lists. And then when they unsubscribed from one list, they were still in the other list. It was really not handy. So what I recommend doing is this. So I recommend that you only use 2 lists. So have a customers list and have a main list and manage everything in there. And then, for example, when someone downloads a lead magnet, you add them to your main list and you give them a tag that says event requested ActiveCampaign cheat sheet, for example, which, by the way, is a real thing. I will also link to that below. So only use 2 lists. And then we're going to talk about tip number 3, which is about keeping your email list clean. So when I got started with email marketing, I wanted to have this huge email list, like the bigger, the better. And I somehow still think that's true, because the more people that are on your list, the more people you can potentially reach. But if you see that people are not actively engaging with your emails, then you should really get those people off your list. So what I recommend doing is to track how long people did not interact with your emails, and then try to re-engage them. And if they're then still not engaging with your emails, it's better to just unsubscribe them. Because with tools like ActiveCampaign, you pay for the amount of active subscribers that you have. So the more active subscribers, the more you pay. And the second thing is that it can also hurt your deliverability. Because if, for example, Gmail sees that people are not opening your emails, then maybe they can start thinking like, those emails are probably spam and you really do not want that. So I created a whole separate tutorial about this. You can see it up here, or I'll put also a link in the description so that you can check that out. You can just create like a cool little system. Now then we're going to talk about tip number 4, which is about message variables. So a message variable is basically like a little snippet that you create, and then you can dynamically insert it in all the emails that you want. So let me show you how you can use that. So message variables you can find under campaign and then manage variables. And then you see that I already have 4 variables over here. So I, for example, have a variable for my signature. So you see here that I have a picture of me and then some text next to it with my name. And then if I use this personalization tag, so signature between these 2% signs, then it will automatically insert in the emails where I use that personalization tag. And that's really handy, because imagine that I want to change my email signature, then instead of having to go over 100 emails, I can just like change it in one place and then it will change everywhere. Now, another one that I have is the greeting variable. And the greeting variable is really simple. It basically just says, hey, Max, or it says hey, hey, based on if I know the first name or not. So these things here is conditional content. We will also talk about that in a bit. And then I have another one, which is my unsubscribe line. So you can see this over here. Here it just says really simple, unsubscribe if you don't want to receive my emails about growing your business with marketing automation anymore, blah, blah, blah. But again, if I ever want to change that unsubscribe line, I only have to do it in one place instead of all my emails. And then we're going to talk about the next tip, which is about creating a really simple email template. So I know that it is super tempting to wanting to create like a really nicely designed, maybe also professional email template. It's also what I did when I just got started, but actually I discovered that the opposite works much better. So this is what I'm using right now, and it works great because it looks like it's an email that comes from a friend. It doesn't look like one big fat promotion like you would usually have with a really nicely designed email template. And this is also really good for deliverability because you don't have a bunch of extra images inside your template, and maybe also you avoid all those extra links that you would maybe have with social media icons or something. So I would really recommend create something like this. If you want to import this example, that's also possible. I will put a link down below so that you can just import it and change to your own needs. Now, then we're going to dive into tip number 6, which is about tracking what people are interested in with a really simple if-else automation so that you can send more relevant emails. Because everybody is unique, and probably also people in your audience, they have different interests. So I, for example, create content about a few different topics. I create content about email marketing, messenger marketing, marketing automation, and also specific tool tutorials like this one about ActiveCampaign. So whenever I send out an email about such content, I would first check, is this person interested in this topic, so that people only get what they want. So this is a simplified version of the automation that I'm using to tag interests. And this automation will start every time a contact visits a page on my website. So I'm doing that with site tracking. And then with if-elses, I check which pages that person visited on my website. So you see, for example, here that if the contact has visited a URL that contains ManyChat 2 to 5 times, then it follows the yes path. And then I add a tag that says interested in topic ManyChat. Or for example, here, I also check something else. So I check, okay, did they visit a page that contains ActiveCampaign 2 to 5 times? Or if they have a tag that says event requested ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. So if any of these two conditions are a match, they follow the yes path, and then a tag gets added that says interest topic ActiveCampaign. And then when I publish this video, for example, and send it to my email list, I check if people have that tag so that people only get emails about things that they're really interested in. So then we're going to talk about tip number 7, and it's a really cool one. It is about conditional content and how you can use it to personalize your emails. So most marketers, they only personalize emails with the first name. And I think if this is all you're doing, you're really missing out. Because what you can do with ActiveCampaign and what you can do with conditional content is that you can swap out little paragraphs inside your emails to make them much, much more relevant based on maybe what someone does or what they struggle with, what they're interested with. So let me show you a cool example. So over here, you see just a simple email, and I'm using this email to deliver a lead magnet. So in this case, the ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. And what is cool here is that inside this email, you see that I have all these different text blocks, right? Well, I did that because for each text block, you can set up a separate condition. So for example, you see that this block has the condition first name exists. So this content will show if all the conditions are met, because you can also set up multiple conditions. Now, if the first name does not exist, then this block will show. So then we'll just say, hey, hey. Now then, what I want to do, if someone is new on my list, I want to say, thanks for joining the list. Glad you found me in this little corner of the internet. From now on, I will send you one valuable email every Tuesday. But I only want to send this to people, like this little paragraph of text, to people who are actually new on the list. Because imagine they're already on my list for a few months. They download the ActiveCampaign cheat sheet, and then they get an email that says, thanks for joining the list. Like, that could be a bit weird. So what I did is I created a simple automation. So once the contact subscribes to any list, Then I add a tag that says status new contact. Then I wait for 30 minutes and then I remove that tag again. So only contacts who are just recently on the list for 30 minutes, only they have the status new contact tag. And then in this block, I can just set up a condition that says, okay, only show this text block if the tag exists, status new contact. So then a little bit more advanced. So right after people opt in on my thank you page, I ask people, what do you sell? Like, do you sell digital products? Do you sell physical products? Or do you sell services? So if somebody would say digital products, I ask, cool, what kind of digital products? And then somebody might say online courses. So then what I do inside this email, I would say, in those emails, we will focus on how you can sell online courses or how you can sell more online courses through marketing automation. And then you can see here that the condition here is tag exist new contact. So it will only show if that person is new on the list and if the custom field specific product equals online course, because when they answer that question, I store online course inside that custom field. Now, if somebody would have a software product, I would say in those emails, we will focus on how you can increase your monthly recurring revenue with marketing automation. Or if someone has a membership website, I would say in those emails, we will focus on how you can get more members with marketing automation. So I hope that this shows how powerful conditional content is, because this is the first email people get. So it's really important. And the people get this like feeling of like, hey, I'm in the right place. And by just personalizing a few paragraphs, you can make it much more relevant. So I hope that you enjoyed these 7 tips for ActiveCampaign. So I created a cool playlist with even more tips. So you can just click that and you can watch even more in-depth tutorials. I will talk about a few more of the things that we just talked about, but also about some tips that I could not cover in this video. And if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below.